Hello everyone, Professor Toybox here along with Sorcerer's Apprentice Mickey, and we'd like to welcome you back to our Fantasia Toybox for another episode of Toybox Tutorials. Last time we talked about enemies, and we finally added some brooms here to our Fantasia Toybox for Mickey to battle. And in the process of the video, I hooked up this Dunbrock Castle gate to an enemy wave generator so that when you enter the castle, as we just did a moment ago, the enemy brooms appear inside the castle. And that works great when I enter the castle. I'm now in this area, so it's okay to have enemies here. The problem is that if we leave the castle through the gate, and the gate opens again, new enemies appear, as you see on the radar. And since we were no longer in the castle, if we wandered off, these enemies would be left in here. The enemy AI would be going and wasting system resources that don't need to be wasted. So how can we prevent that from happening? Well, there's a number of ways to do that, but one way to do it is with the logic gate. And that's the topic of today's lesson. So you'll find the logic gate inside the Creativitoys drawer. And it's actually a very simple toy. This diagram might help. Here we have the Dunbrock Castle gate and the enemy wave generator. The arrow connecting the two represents the logic connection between them. Think of this arrow as a water pipe connecting the two toys. The water, or logic signal in our case, flows through the pipe from one toy to the other. If a logic connection is like a pipe, then a logic gate is like a valve. It sits on the pipe between the water source and its destination, and with the valve open, doesn't really do anything, it just allows the water to flow through it. However, if you close the valve, it prevents the water from traveling from the source to its destination. The same is true with the logic gate. It sits between the two toys, just like the valve does. The source toy inputs its trigger signal into the logic gate, and the logic gate in turn outputs the signal to its destination. By default, the logic gate is open, so the logic signal just passes through it. But the logic gate can be closed, preventing the signal from traveling from one toy to the other. So let's look at a practical example of this, and we'll see how this logic gate helps solve my problem. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to come over here to the castle gate and open the logic menu for this. And right now it has a direct connection to the enemy wave generator. And since we need to put the logic gate in between the two, I'm going to delete this link, and I do that on the Wii U by pressing Y. And so now I can go through the castle gate, and it's not going to invoke the enemy wave generator. So now we'll come over here and drop the logic gate down. And the logic gate, as I said, is pretty simple. You'll note if I bring the menu up, there are no properties to set. It's basically just a pass-through that you can open and close. So there's nothing to do to set that up. So we'll come over to the castle gate, and I'm going to do a new logic connection so that when the gate is opened, as you saw in the diagram, we'll come to the logic gate and we'll input to the gate. And now from the logic gate, we'll open the logic menu and do a new logic connection. And on output from the gate, when the logic gate outputs, we come to the enemy wave generator, and we generate the wave. So now we have the Dunbrock Castle gate connected back up to the enemy wave generator, but there's a logic gate sitting in between the two. And right now, because the gate is open by default, there's no change in behavior from what we had before. So if we walk through the gate, the enemy spawns, and he's over here this time. And we delete him, or defeat him, and I pick up my sparks because I don't want to lose out on those. And if we walk through the gate, again, the logic gate's still open, so we still have the same problem that we had before. There we go. But we now have the logic gate sitting in between the two, which means we can close it. So I'm going to come back outside the castle and go back into spark mode here. So we can set up a logic connection now from the enemy wave generator. Do a new logic connection. When the wave is generated, we'll come over to the logic gate and close it. So now, walking through the castle gate, we'll pass through the open logic gate to the enemy wave generator and generate the wave. And when the wave has been generated, this will turn around and invoke the logic gate to close it. So now if we run through the gate, we're outside the gate. La 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 la. No enemies in there eating up resources. Until we enter the gate. And now the broom shows up. There we go. But generating him caused the logic gate to be closed, so now we can exit the gate. And you'll notice on my radar, there's no enemies appearing. So we can walk through this gate now as many times as we want. We're not going to have any enemies show up. So that means the enemies will only show up the first time we walk through the gate. And since we're starting on the outside of the castle, that works out pretty well. The enemies don't show up until we're inside the castle, and we're expecting to see them at that point. And when we leave the castle, there are no enemies. So that's the logic gate. Use it whenever you need to be able to block a logic signal and turn that signal on or off. That's really all the logic gate does. It's a pretty simple toy, as I said. We'll be using it again in future videos, so you'll get to see more examples of how to use it as we go through this series. I hope you found today's video helpful, and if so, please give it a like, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel or sign up on my blog so you don't miss the next episode in this series. Thank you for watching, and have a great weekend.